Kevin. Obviously, outstanding performance. What was working for you tonight?
You know, our offense is so deep. With guys like Benny coming back from injury, and Callum's playing some of the best across his life, you know, they got to concentrate on those guys. So it gave me a little bit more space tonight than I'd usually have, and luckily things dropped for me.
We talked about with Sullivan, you had a great practice this week. A lot of things working for you. Does that help lead into a game like this?
One thing we try and do differently than most other teams. I mean, we practice like before a game like most teams, but I think we actually, I've been, you know, seen how other teams do. I think we practice harder than other teams. We try and make it a pretty game-like situation. So obviously, you know, that helps, and you're more ready to go when you time the ball drops and the game starts.
Do you kind of put that scoring load on yourself? I mean, obviously you have great players like Benesh and Crawford. Do you expect yourself to be able to put in a few goals a game?
Yeah, I think as I've, you know, my career's kind of gone along, my role's starting to change a little bit more to being a guy that hopefully the coaches can count the ball in the net when we need that. And I think tonight I sort of stepped up in that role, and I'm happy with that performance.
5-2 deficit midway through the first, and then Swamp go on an 11-2 run, you know, all the way through the end of the third. What changed from point A to point B?
One thing that we really, you know, try and focus on is that it's a game of runs. You know, they're going to get their runs, we're going to get our runs. It's really important. It's a long game, not to get too high, not to get too low. And even last game, I think Washington came out and scored the first two goals within 10 seconds or something. So when we went down by a couple, like, okay, it's a long game, no problem. Battle back, even it up, go on our run. The game's full of peaks and valleys, and just trying to, anytime they get a run, we get to answer one of our own.
How does that set you up for the last game of the season and playoffs?
You know, going into the playoffs, it's so important to go in on a high note. So often you see teams sort of crawl into the playoffs or fall in after losing two or three in a row, and just not ready to go, no confidence in the first round of the playoffs. So to get these past two wins, going to play a very good Colorado team next week. If we can come out with that win, 9-7 into the playoffs is the best team I've ever been on here. And, you know, carry the momentum, and who knows how far we can go.
Was it you? There was like one player just on the stretch of his stick was able to score just before touching the crease.
Yeah, that was me. I know
that was one of your. Yeah. Describe that. That was perhaps the hot razzle dazzle play of the game.
That's one of the things I'm known for, but I do quite a bit is getting underneath and going to the net, getting real close to that crease. And I think I might have more flags thrown and challenged goals than anyone in lacrosse. But I saw an opening underneath and took it. And you know, it was close. I think if the ref could do it again, maybe he'd call it back. But luckily, he saw it the way I was hoping he would.
15 goals tonight, Kevin. Do you guys think your offense is capable of doing this on a nightly basis?
I think so. I mean, you know, our offense aims to score, but, you know, anywhere between 13, 15, and above wherever we go out. We've got the talent to do that. We've got the depth to do that. And there really isn't a reason we can't do that. And on the nights we can't, I mean, think back to some of the games, the Edmonton game we won in overtime, or the Rochester game that weekend, where, you know, our offense wasn't really clicking, so our defense and goaltenders stepped up. And it really takes the 26 guys in that room, you know, all the guys playing, all the guys not even dressed, to put together a win. So hopefully our offense can put up those numbers, but, I mean, if we can't, we're confident in our defensive goaltending.
Kevin, last night, we were just talking practice, hot stick. Did you just kind of have a good feeling coming in tonight, and just as a play in general?
Yeah, I think, you know, you find sort of a routine that works, and I've been trying to stick to that routine most of the year this year. This week was no different. We had a good practice last night, like I said, you know, trying to mimic the game as much as possible. You know, worked in, got a lot of shots, and the stick was feeling good. So I had confidence going into today, but no different than the other game. You know, you want to make sure you're confident as an offensive player going into the game.
How about just winning this one for Joe Lawson? I know you guys share a moment there in the locker room too with Joe.
Joe's such a great guy. I mean, he's so quiet and so selfless, and you know, even presenting out here, I'm sure that was even kind of tough for him getting all that attention, but he's such a great guy, just a hard worker, heart and soul kind of player, great teammate, and to put something together like that for him tonight, on a night really special and, you know, close to my heart personally as well, it's, it was, you know, this one means a lot.
Thanks, all
set.